Sports.
Welcome to Snapdragon Stadium in San Diego, California, home to the Aztecs of San Diego State. Being in San Diego is never a bad thing, and it's even better when you have a matchup like this one. Today, we're set for a clash between these two rivals from the Mountain West. As we'll see, the Wyoming Cowboys taking on a squad hoping to prevent another L this week, the San Diego State Aztecs. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollock, and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. And the Cowboys will get us started with the opening kickoff. That one bounds through the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. Here comes the offense on first down. They'll put the tight end in motion. Off the play fake on first down, wants to throw. And the pass is intercepted. He'll try to take it back. And the senior just snatched the ball out of the air and gave it back to his offense.
And I know this defense statistically hasn't been one of the best against the pass this year, but they have had some guys banged up. They believe they've got difference makers on the back end that just need to make more plays. That DB right there is one of those guys, and he doesn't here on the opening drive getting a huge interception.
Knocked down at the 27 after a pickup of 5.
Hey, 5 to 6 yards a pop. I don't know if you guys are really good at math, but that usually equals a first down every couple carries. So don't forget about the run game. Keep them honest. Pound that rock.
Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. One back in the backfield, and they'll give it to him. And he picked up the first down, but he will remember the price he paid after that hit.
And a great job by the offensive line. You're going to run the ball right at the middle. You better control the line of scrimmage. You can see the center, the guard, the tackles doing a good job getting on their guys just enough where this running back can get into space and make the big gain.
A first down run on the doorstep. He bullies his way all the way down to the 5-yard line.
At the 5-yard line. Brings up 2nd and goal.
Defense trying to come up with a stop on second and goal. He'll run it to the right here and try to get it into the end zone. He's got it down to the 1 yard line right on the doorstep of Pater.
Well, he gets tackled down at the 1 yard line, so offensively, do you feel confident enough on third here trying to hand it off again?
Yeah, and I'm taking both these downs, and I'm coming downhill. I'm running the football, trying to get this in the end zone. I only got a yard to go. I gotta be physical.
They'd love to make this short field payoff with a touchdown instead of settling for three, but it is third and goal. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, Wyoming.
Touchdown.
And I love it. I love the physicality of this offense. It's third and goal. I trust my offensive line to pave the way, give the ball to my running back, and know he's going to physically punch this thing into the end zone.
And he tacked on the extra point.
Wyoming, 7, San Diego State, 0.
About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. He brought that thing out of the end zone with the idea of making a play, but he didn't even get back to the 25. San Diego State takes over as the offense is ready to go to work. Well, the good news about this drive, Jesse, it can't go worse than last time through a pick on the first play.
No, it certainly can't. I think
nothing but green ahead. He's at the 30. He's at the 10. And he ran away from the crowd, and he'll take it in. Touchdown, San Diego State.
Man, this guy is such a weapon because he's so dangerous. If he gets into the second level, great vision, and then David just shows you the speed.
Just straight wheels, erasing angles. A lot of times when you're chasing guys that are so fast like this, you're like, I got him. No, I do not. What a big long touchdown run. Pad those stats, young fella.
He'll bring it back from inside his five. And good work by the coverage team to knock down the return man. They've got the big fellas out there. A three tight end look on first and 10. On the run, it's Hobbs. Across the 25, he's got room. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
You know, they pride themselves on being physical at the point of attack, dominated at the line of scrimmage. Nice job there picking up the first down.
They get him stopped at the 32. That's a gain of 4.
Just a simple power play, power football. Be strong, be big, be physical. Make it a fourth quarter game. Make them feel you. Keep them off balance.
After the productive first down play, it's second and 6. Anderson wants to throw. Gets it to the back. And they wrap him up, but not before he gets enough on the catch for the first down.
And a great job by the QB, finding the running back, get him the football where he can do some damage after the catch, and most importantly, get the first down.
Here's the handoff. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry.
Yeah, this off, man, you got to do a better job blocking. And I tell you what, that's kind of been a theme throughout the season. They haven't been high-powered. They haven't really figured out who they are yet. And they still got time. The season's not over yet. But this offense, still in identity mode.
He's looking for a man on second down. Finds his man. It's Briggs. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down. The Cowboys come to the line with a fresh set of downs. We'll give him a couple on that one. Second and 8 coming up.
And these defensive tackles just eat people. They swallow human beings when you get near them. They're so big, so strong. Those guys, those running backs coming, they just need a mitt. They put one mitt on a running back, and he usually falls to the ground just because of their sheer mass and strength.
And the freshman does a great job using his technique and getting the man on the ground.
And a nice second effort by the back to break a tackle. But how about those defensive backs willing to come up, stick their face in the fan, and make a tackle?
Those are the best run defenses too, right? It's not just D linemen and linebackers getting all the plays, but it's DBs that are willing to not just cover, but tackle.
And the defense is all over the quarterback, and down he goes. The number one job is to protect their quarterback, and they did not.
They did not. But my number one job as a defensive lineman is to attack your quarterback and get him on the ground just like this, get in the sack, rattle this guy as much as you can, as many hits as possible on these quarterbacks.
Coverage was all over him before he had a chance to breathe, and they knock him down deep in his own territory. Final play of the quarter coming. They go to the ground. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense. Quick pass on the jet motion. He's brought down, but he went backwards after that completion, not the way they had it drawn up.
I like offenses being creative. I'm not sure if that was the best place to call that play. I think this offense needs to think about just doing things a little bit more by the book. They've got a lot of good playmakers. You don't have to reinvent the wheel this early in the game.
The give to the back. Just buried it. He's now up to 95 yards on the ground, and he's been terrific all season, ranking in the top 10 in rushing. Looking for that first down on third and short from the 28. They want to throw it. Coming after it. That pass not closes. He got drilled trying to deliver it, and it'll bring up fourth down.
QBs and receivers on third down, everything has to happen just a split second sooner. You're expecting pressure. The quarterback gets hit, just not on the same page with his target.
On fourth down, going to the air. Complete and looking for enough for the first down. Not much of a fourth down gamble when it's that much of a sure thing. An easy conversion for this offense.
And they are showing you their intentions early in the game. It's fourth down, you're in your own end. We're going to be aggressive, and we're not just going to do this early. We're going to do this all game long. Awesome execution on a critical down.
And the running back didn't get much there. Nice job by the defense. You can tell they're focused in on this running back, on this run game, being physical, getting knockbacks, and limiting his carries.
On second down, looking to throw. And it's intercepted. A turnover from the defense. Taking it the other way. At the 30. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Cowboys. The defense puts six on the board with a big-time interception return.
Really nice drive by this offense. This is a top 10 defense. This is a challenge. They're going to make everything difficult. So when you can make some plays against this defense, you got to absolutely take advantage, create some momentum for your squad. Nice drive by this offense.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by seven. Let's go to the studio now and check in with Kevin Connors. Kevin, what do you got?
A bit of an under-the-radar game this week, guys, but take a look at this. Miami is down big on the scoreboard, and for a program that traditionally struggles to score, I think we know where this one is headed. They're trailing by 14 to Ball State. Just another week of college football where we've come to expect the unexpected, fellas.
And how about that one? Kevin will be keeping an eye on everything going on elsewhere. He's moving out of the pocket. And he got smacked just as he released the pass. It's incomplete.
Yeah, and your first job is to affect the quarterback and try to get him off his spot. They get him off the spot, he gets outside the pocket, and a nice job chasing, not quitting, getting to the quarterback, and still getting a good lick as he's throwing the football.
From the gun, the running back tries to hit the hole. Oh, big juke to get past. works his way to the 41, and that is plenty to give him a first down.
Yeah, and this offense is built behind this guy. I mean, a guy that you can hand the football to consistently and expect positive yards all day long, all game long. Now he's over 100 yards on the day.
At the 45 on his way. Defense caught out of position, and they get him down finally at the 38. You count up those explosive plays in the game, and you put a little extra star by the big run.
Yeah, and this running back is a weapon, boy. He is so good in space. He's got shiftiness. He can make guys miss. And if this guy gets into the second level, watch out. He can hit a home run.
When you're a defense, it is stop the run first. That is your first responsibility. It makes the whole game easy. And right now, they got it going on the ground. The defense is going to change something up. These little tiny dink and dunk. You keep doing this, they'll go all the way down the field on you. So you might want to get a little bit more aggressive.
Working on the right. Huge game before he goes out of bounds, and now they've got it first and goal. The Aztecs want to pick up the tempo. They'll try to power it in. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
And you got to get locked in the red zone. A lot of defensive coordinators, they'll tell you, we'll give up yards, but we got to understand what we're trying to get accomplished. Great job down here near the goal line. This defense bowing their neck up.
And he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Aztecs.
And the offense continues to run the football. The second rushing touchdown from the running back. The offensive line made holes and continue to feed this man the ball.
And they add the extra point to finish the drive. That is an efficient drive. 7 plays, 75 yards. And he got into the house from the 6 to finish it. And he hauls it in, and everybody's on the edge of their seats. And good work by the coverage team to get the return man down on the ground. First down here with time for maybe one more play until the 2-minute warning. Running back searching for a hole. It's these little moments like that that can help an offense as he gets it up to the 16-yard line. Kept it on the ground on first down. See if they stick with that plan on second. From the gun, the give, looking for room. Really nice stop there from this senior leader.
Well, man, there's some big hitting going on in the trenches right now. This defense, they take a lot of pride in stopping the run. Let's keep our eye on them throughout the course of the game and see if they can contain this running attack.
Third and short, they've got them back up inside the 20, and the D can get the ball back here. Trying to pick it up on the ground. And the defense knew exactly where that first down line was, and they stopped him short. Running for it on fourth down. And the runner is down, and so is a flag. Just an obvious holding call there, and one that just kills an offense's momentum. And the Cowboys will send out the punt unit. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. Fair catch called for and made. Line gets set, first down. He'll start this drive firing. Now adjusting. He's going to take off. At the 35, he's open. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down. Out of the gun, the running back has it. They'll wrestle him down just short of the first down. I don't even think they're going to bring out the chains to measure this one.
Man, when I can run the football like that on first down and create second and inches and stay way ahead of the sticks and be in a position now where I can throw the football or run, I will have a lot of success on the offensive side of the football.
That penalty moves the ball back 10 yards. We'll replay the down.
All right, let's get it.
They'll line up for a second down play. He's looking to throw. Get it out on the screen. Didn't have much room to run and not a whole lot of help. Short gain there and still plenty of ground to cover for the first down. You know, sometimes even a short gain like that can be used to set up something bigger later on.
No doubt, Reese, they can pump that and take a shot down the field. And don't worry, they're going to go back to that same play because they know this guy with the ball in his hands is dangerous. He makes one guy miss, he can take it to the house.
Quick timeout from the offense to save precious seconds.
Timeout, San Diego State.
Perhaps emboldened by converting a fourth down earlier in the game, they'll try a second time. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Makes the catch, he's got enough. He was working his way toward that goal line. They'll stop him at the two after the big play up top. A fresh set of downs after that fourth down conversion, but still the up-tempo as they get to the line quickly. They'll run it. Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, San Diego State.
And that is exactly what you want from your offense. Man, late in the half, you want to execute and then punch it in physically on the ground. Take the lead going into the half. Take all the momentum. Nice execution of the drive by that offense.
So here comes the kickoff after the touchdown, and the last thing you need right before the half is to give up a big return. Here he comes from inside his own five. And the returner will be brought down.
And the Wyoming offense will take over. First and ten.
Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. Use the play fake, now to throw. Trying to beat the D deep. Pass falls incomplete, and there are still 3 seconds left.
DB does an outstanding job here on the deep pass, locating the football, no PI, able to swat it away, pass incomplete.
Fires to the right, into double coverage, and it's intercepted. And he'll be brought down, and that's how we'll end the first half. We played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update. We're ready to get it started here in the second half. On the move from inside his five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Wyoming has the football back, and here comes the offense. Maybe adjustments or attitude adjustments, but they've got to find a way to run the ball at least some here in the second half.
I do think you said something that's important. I think running the football is an attitude. Like, it starts with the offensive lineman and being physical, having a nasty attitude. Running back, same thing. I think they need more of that in the second half.
You know, and I think even if you're this defense, you have an opportunity to make a statement here. Yeah, I know you guys went in at halftime and you riled yourselves up and you told yourself that you think you can run the ball on us. On this very first drive, we're going to prove to you, just like in the first 30 minutes, you cannot.
With a first down, they'll snap it from the 32. Linebackers trying to create some confusion. Good job running tough and behind his pads as he gets up to the 38-yard line.
And after having a nice game like that on first down, if you're the offensive coordinator here, maybe you're thinking about being aggressive and taking a shot. Because even if it's incomplete on second down, on third, you won't have that long to go.
It's a reverse. He's knocked down in the backfield, a swarming defense, and he'll lose seven.
And you gotta love this if you're the defensive coordinator, because your defense stayed disciplined. They didn't over-pursue to the running back. They stayed home, played great with their eyes, and were able to make the tackle.
On third and long, try to convert through the air. Fires into traffic, intercepted. He goes down right there, but not before coming up with a big interception.
And we know turnover margin is a huge part of winning ball games. Interception number two. This quarterback has to do a better job taking care of the football. Don't force it. Take the high completion percentage stuff. Don't always try to go for the big play.
Not able to break the big one on that screen to the running back, but he found enough and a solid pickup on first down.
I'll tell you what, if you want to be overzealous and you want to be a blitzer all the time, I like running the screen right behind him. Did a great job throwing the screen. Almost broke this one for a long game, but it just keeps the defense a little bit more honest if you want to start bringing a lot of pressure.
He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. Let's go. Ball's at the 24. A lot of confidence in their kicker from here, but they'd love to take it off of his foot and convert the first down. But jet sweep pass. Got some room, headed to the goal line. Into the hallelujah land. Touchdown, Aztecs. The offense strikes again to extend its lead here in the second half.
And they got everything working. How great is this? You extend your lead, now you get your defense back on the field. Great job taking advantage of the situation and building on that lead.
And for a quick update, let's go to Kevin Connors in the studio.
Week in and week out, guys, you never know what's going to happen in college football. Check this out. Florida Atlantic has dug itself a hole today, and I don't think they're climbing out of that puppy. Huge interest in this game, and they have rolled over. They're trailing by 21 to Duke. Any big developments in this one, we've got you covered with the best studio team in the business, gentlemen.
Oh, and how about that? I know Kevin and those guys will be keeping an eye on it for us. Wyoming takes over the football, and the Cowboy offense on its way out. This is when the pressure can ramp up a little bit on an offense, David, when they start feeling the heat to answer a score.
And I think being down 14, you can kind of feel that way. But, dude, if you put a good drive together, this is a seven-point game. So, Palmer, no need to panic.
I was just going to say, David, I mean, this thing can flip quick. You go down, score, all of a sudden your defense gets a stop, or who knows, better yet, gets a turnover. This game is entirely different.
From the gun, the ground game. And you can forget running in the middle against this defense.
It's an offense that takes pride in being physical. They try to get it going on the ground, but no gain on that one.
Just nowhere to run, not a lot of wiggle room for the ball carrier.
This defense came in knowing that they had to match their physicality. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Anderson will throw. Fires to the wideout. Finds a man on the left. And a nice grab there. Big pickup down to the 35-yard line. And they just want to give this guy a chance to make a play on third down. And more times than not, he is going to deliver.
He's so good. So efficient. Such a good route runner. Got the speed. Got the complete game. So you definitely want to highlight it. And especially on those downs that matter the most. If something's not open quick underneath, find him. He'll make those contested catches.
Hey, man, sometimes you get the perfect play call at the perfect time. That time, the defense blitzing, offensive line allowed everybody to run upfield, and they slip in the running back screen, and behind it, there was nobody there to make a tackle. And this offense generates a massive play.
He stopped just a chain link or two away from the first down and sets them up beautifully here. Time winding down in the quarter as they come to the line. They'll leave it with him. And he'll race it to the house. Touchdown, Mustard and Brown. Got to start cutting into this lead somewhere. Now the question, will they have enough time?
But that's step one. You got to get that first score. You got to get back in the ballgame and get some of that momentum back on your side. You still got more work to do, but step one accomplished.
Here comes the two-point try. They'll try to pound their way in. He's not quite going to get there, and the try for two fails, and they are unable to cut into this lead any further. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. The ball squirts through the end zone. That'll be a touchback. They'll bring it out to the 25. And they'll get off one more play before the end of the quarter. Running to the left. Keeps the legs moving. Lowers that shoulder, delivers the blow. They get him down, and that'll be the final play of the third period. They'll break the seal on this quarter here on first down. He's looking to throw it. Moving, keeping the eyes downfield. Just couldn't find an open man. He'll get rid of it, and it'll be second down.
And that goes down as incompletion, but that's a smart play. And the QB coach and the OC will be very happy with the decision of the quarterback. He got outside the pocket. He obviously was, so he's outside the tackle boxes. He knew he could throw it away as long as he got it past the line of scrimmage. Nothing there, nothing open. Live to fight another down.
Leaves it with the back. Still on his feet at the 45. And he will finally go out of bounds after another big gain, and they are absolutely gashing them with this running game. And the Aztecs getting set on first and 10. Motion from the offense. Touch pass on the run. A solid pickup there before the defense is able to make the stop.
And these little touch passes, man, they're just the easiest completions ever for quarterbacks. Palmer, I bet you would have loved being able to just flip it forward. That counts as to your completion percentage, which is good. And then it's all run after the catch, so pretty easy for a QB.
You wouldn't have been the only All-American in this booth, Garrett, if I were allowed to have push passes when I was playing quarterback. I'll tell you that. It is so hard to defend. It's so hard to seal that edge, especially when this guy's full speed ahead coming around the inside.
The snap sets up to throw. They've got the screen set up. And they stop him just short of the stick. It'll bring up a decision on fourth down.
And after that completion, it's decision time now for the head coach. Do you kick a field goal, add to your lead, and make it more difficult on the opposing offense? Or do you trust your quarterback to make one more big completion here and ice the game?
That keeps the score. San Diego State, 28, Wyoming.
Okay. Wyoming has the football back, and here comes the offense. Anderson wants to throw. Swings it out to the flat. He is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose yards on that one. Now on second down. These DBs going to give a little cushion. Wants to fire on second down. Throws to the wideout. Can't make the grab. Quarterback just missed him a little bit.
Yeah, and I don't know what happened. He didn't look open as it is, and the QB's trying to make a play, trying to force the ball, but at least he threw it where his guy could catch it or nobody could catch it.
Somebody needs to make a play here. It's third and long from the 26. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. Tremendous awareness along the sideline and the ability to get the foot down for the big pickup. The offense lines up at the 41 with a first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. He's piled up 82 yards on the ground, and that's just another routine day for this guy who's been among the nation's leaders in rushing all season long. That kind of pickup on first down, and you can take a shot here on second and short. He's looking to throw. They're trying to get to him. That pass is incomplete, and they might be fortunate it wasn't knocked free for a fumble. It'll be third down.
And imagine the defense in this scenario, right? You're up by one possession. You need to get to the quarterback. You've got to affect him. You're going to blitz, or you're going to try to win one-on-one up front. They did it that time, hit him, and forced the incompletion.
Nice job to pick up the first down, and they'll spot it at the 42.
And listen, the offensive line has to do their job, but a really good job by the running back, understanding where his hole is. Go hit it, get the first down, don't mess around. Nice job following his hole, getting positive yards.
The Cowboys are rolling down the field.
29 Philly, 2-9 Philly.
Wide receiver coming across in motion. The give to the tailback. They'll pick up 4, 2nd and 6 coming.
Small gain, I know, but again, the defense knows he's going to run the football. He's willing to run the football, not just drop back and pass. Make him honor the run game. You got to do a lot of this.
Toss sweep right. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
One offense, you've got to love the way your offensive line is playing in this game. They're getting tremendous movement up front. They're climbing in the second level and really giving these backs and ball carriers a lot of room to run all game long.
Defense is about firing off, hitting the offensive guys, and staying in your gaps, everybody knowing where they're supposed to be. You could tell the defense, everyone was right where they're supposed to be, nowhere to run.
Caught over the middle, it's Stevenson. He knew exactly where he wanted to go with that one, and they've got enough for the first down. Defense has to be frustrated. The offense keeps matriculating and matriculating and matriculating the ball down the field. Wide receiver now comes in motion. They run the reverse. Touchdown, Wyoming. And they take it in for 6 more points.
And this is obviously a no-brainer. Great job by the offense. Great execution. Inside of 2 minutes, you've got to go for two. You got to dial up this play. Try to tie this football game up. What's your favorite two-point play? Dial it up, and let's tie this game up.
Anderson will throw. And he was hit just as he was releasing the pass, and it falls to the ground incomplete. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. It bounds through the back of the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. The Aztecs offense ready to go back to work. Okay, Jesse, this is a little bit of a tight spot. You'd love to be aggressive enough to get the first down, but you've got to take care of the ball first.
No doubt. I was going to say, ball security is at a premium. You cannot turn the football over at this point. The defense has 3 timeouts left, David, so probably conservative play calling here. You're expecting them to try to run to ice this game.
Conservative, I know they're going to be aggressive, but I also know that one first down ends this football game.
He almost picked up the first down on that one, but he'll be just a little bit short. Quick timeout call by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. Lining up to convert 3rd down. They'll keep it on the ground, trying to milk the clock. That just never had a chance as they controlled the middle of the field and stopped him in the backfield on 3rd down. They have the lead in a 1-possession game, but they're thinking deliver the knockout blow, but this carries big-time risk on 4th down. And they are stopped on... That decision will be questioned.
And as a defense, that's all you can ask for. Give the ball back to your offense. Yes, you're still down. You gave them a chance. They got the football. They got some time left. Now can they put a drive together, maybe go tie this game, maybe go win this game. Great stop by this defense.
The give from the gun.
That's a really good job by the defense, wrapping them up, getting them on the ground. Take away that run game. Make them one-dimensional, put them in passing situations. Really good job by the defense.
After picking up a couple at 2nd and 8. The defense going to stop the clock with a timeout. They want to make sure they have everybody on the same page. 2nd down coming up.
Here we go.
Looking for room. It's Guzman. And he is swarmed under a host of defenders there to make the stop. The defense calls the timeout, and that's their last one of the half. This is the type of play that decides games. Are you tough enough to convert third and short from the 30? They'll give it to the back. And they're able to get a third down stop here. See if they go for it on fourth. A huge pressurized kick coming right now as this game hangs in the balance. And he'll try to boot them into the lead in the final minute. The attempt is no good, but there is a flag down, and he might get another shot at this one. The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. The offense will gladly take a fresh set of downs after the penalty. They'll try the left side. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. Anderson wants to throw. He wants it all. And good hands there by the defense on that shot to the end zone.
One of the things you have to be impressed about this defense is that they've got guys in the back end who can cover man-to-man or zone. That last one gets swatted away. They're in a situation where they're expecting pass. You know this is going to be a tight window to throw into if you're the quarterback here.
That last field goal looks like the game winner if they can keep them from getting in field goal range here right at the end. And as the ball makes its way into the end zone, it'll be a touchback. They'll bring it out to the 25. Remember, all they have to do is get it close enough for a field goal here. Quarterback making adjustments with his receivers. Looking to scramble. He's taking a deep shot late in the game. And the deep shot is complete inside the 35-yard line. And they fight him to the bitter end all the way down to putting some more numbers in the stat column, but they'll come up a little short as time expires. That's the entire scenario you build up in your head in the backyard. Final drive, everything on the line, and you get the W.
So dang cool. How many times did you do it in your backyard just like that, like you're talking about, Reese, making the play to win the game on the final drive when your team needed it the most, Jesse, just coming through in the clutch?
Yeah, as players, you love this, and that's why you rep it in practice throughout the week, these two-minute type situations late in games. What are you going to dial up? What can you go execute? What can you lean on in order to get the W here? Great job by the offense.
So that's going to do it for us. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis saying so long. This has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.